بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه. أما بعد, this is our 11th lesson going through the poem المقدمة الجزرية فيما يجب على قارئ القرآن أن يعلمه, authored by الإمام ابن الجزري رحمه الله تعالى. We stopped at line number 65, باب أحكام النون الساكنة والتنوين. قال المصنف رحمه الله, وحكم تنوين ونون يلفى إظهار إدغام وقلب إخفاء. So in here we're going to be speaking about أحكام النون الساكنة والتنوين. And again, we studied this in detail in level 1, تحفة الأطفال. للنون إن تسكن وللتنوين أربع أحكام فخذ تمين. And so we spoke about a definition of the نون الساكنة. Remember, letters in the Arabic language can have either a vowel or exist vowelless. So the vowels are three, فتحة كسرة ضمة. And then we have the non-vowel, which is the sukun. And so we're talking about the noon one, when it is in the state of sukun. And likewise, the tanween is a noon ساكنة زائلة تلحق آخر الأسماء لفظا لا خطا وصلا لا وقفا. And we explain this in detail in level 1, تحفة الأطفال. So when we have a noon ساكنة or a tanween and it's followed by any one of the Arabic letters, then they're going to be one of four rulings. These letters are going to be categorized into one of four. Either the noon ساكنة will be recited with إظهار, or with إدغام, or with إقلاب, or with إخفاء. And we mentioned إظهار linguistically means البيان, to make something clear and apparent, meaning that the noon is to be recited from its articulation point. Likewise, when we said إدغام, it means merging. And so what happens here, there's going to be a form of merging that takes place between the noon ساكن and the letter from the letters of الإدغام. Likewise, إقلاب means to flip over or to change something. And so what happens here, you have this ميم ساكن is to be changed, is to be flipped into a hidden ميم with a غنة, as we will see inshallah تعالى. And then we have the إخفاء. The إخفاء is the final of the four categories where the meme is to be recited in a hidden fashion. والله تعالى أعلم. The author رحمه الله, he begins with حكم الإظهار, where he says فعند حرف الحلق أظهر والدغم في اللام والراء لا بغنة اللزم. So here he says that عند حروف الحلق, when the نون ساكنة is followed by any one of the throat letters, which we know is six throat letters, للحلق ست رتبت فالتعريف همز فهاء ثم عين حاء مهملتان ثم غين خاء, as mentioned by الجمزوري رحمه الله تعالى. And ابن الجزري mentioned as well in باب مخارج الحروف, فألف الجوف وأختاها وهي حروف مد للهواء تنتهي ثم لأقصى الحلق همز هاء ثم لوصله فعين حاء أدناه غين خاؤها. And so these are the six letters if they follow the نون ساكنة or the تنوين, whether it be in one word or in two words, like ينأون ينهون فسينغضون منخنقة طيب تنحتون مثلا. You find that whether it's one word or two words, like من آمن طيب, whether it's a تنوين حليما غفورا مثلا, you have to do إظهار, you have to make إظهار, you pronounce the نون from its articulation point. Then he said والدغم, so that's the first category of الإظهار. The second category والدغم في اللام والراء لا بغنة اللزم وأدغما بغنة في يومن إلا بكلمة كدنيا عنون. So the إدغام, we mentioned it's a form of merging that takes place, and this merging can be of two types, complete إدغام, incomplete إدغام. In its complete إدغام, when the lam and the ra come after the noon ساكنة, like من لدنه من ربهم, طيب, there's complete إدغام here. And as for the and we call the إدغام بغير غنة. And as for the second category, then إدغام بغنة, and that is gathered together in the, or these letters are gathered together in the word يومن. And we mentioned in تحفة الأطفال the gathering together into the word ينمو. Both are correct, okay? So the idgham here that takes place when you have a ya following the nun sakina, or a mim following the nun sakina, or a waw following the nun sakina, or a nun following the nun sakina, is idgham bi ghunna. Or we call it in the Arabic language idgham naqis, or in the English language incomplete idgham, meaning the sifat al-ghunna will remain. The sifat al-ghunna remains. And the ghunna is of course sifat mulazimat min harf al-nun. So you say man yaqulu, min walin, طيب, min ma'in mahin, طيب. For example, min nafs wahidatin. طيب, you have to come with this إدغام بغنة. The exception here is إلا بكلمتين. So when we say إدغام بغنة, we qualify it that it must be between two words. So the ending of the first word must have a نون ساكنة or a تنوين, and the beginning of the second word must have a the letter from the letters of يومن, either a واو or a واو or a ميم or a نون. However, if this relationship occurs in the middle of a word, of course, if you have a نون ساكنة followed by a ياء or followed by a واو in one word, in the same word, then of course what happens here is what is going to be an إظهار, and we call it إظهار مطلق. And we mentioned this in Al-Jamzuri, that it occurs in four words, بنيان, دنيا, قنوان, and صنوان. And he mentioned, Ibn al-Jazari mentioned two examples, دنيا and عنوان. عنوان never came in the Quran. عنوان عنوان means address. It never came in the Quran. What came in the Quran is بنيان, صنوان, قنوان, and دنيا. والله تعالى أعلم. Then the author رحمه الله said, والقلب عند الباب غنة كذا لإخفال باقي الحروف أخيذا. Here he mentions the final two categories, the إقلاب and the إخفاء. The إقلاب of course occurs when you have a nun ساكنة or a تنوين followed by a letter باء or the letter باء. What happens here is the باء causes the nun sakinah to be flipped into a hidden meme, a meme mukhfa ma'a al-gunnah. What did al-Jamzuri say? وَالثَّالِثُ الْإِقْلَابُ عِنْدَ الْبَاءِ مِيمًا بِغُنَّةِ مَعَ الْإِخْفَاءِ. So the iqlab that takes place and the nun is switched, is flipped into a hidden meme and it's accompanied with a gunnah. It is accompanied with a gunnah. مِن بَعْدِهِمْ لَفِي شَكٍ مِّنْهُ مُرِيب. Of course, لَفِي شَكٍ مِّنْهُ, that's idgham. You have a tanween, شَكٍ مِّنْهُ is a meme. مكسوره, so there's gonna be what? A idgham بغنة لا في شك منه. So that's the second category. But من بعدهم here there's إقلاب. And the إقلاب here is that the nun sakinah is switched into a hidden meme accompanied with a غنة. As for the final category, then it is the إخفاء. And so any of the remaining letters gathered together by الجمزوري رحمه الله تعالى in the phrase صف ذا ثنا كم جاد شخص قد سما دم طيبا زد في تقم ضع ظالما. صف ذا ثنا كم جاد شخص قد سما دم طيبا زد في تقم ضع ظالما. We spoke about this in detail and we gave examples for that in level 1 تحفة الأطفال. And so if these letters صف, the صاد, the ذال and so on, the first letters of each word in the acronym صف ذا ثنا كم جاد شخص قد سما دم طيبا زد في تقم ضع ظالما, if these letters come after the نون ساكنة or the تنوين, then what's going to happen is that this نون ساكنة is to be recited with إخفاء. It is to be made hidden. من في أو مثلا من فضل أنصدوكم, there's going to be an element of إخفاء. And the way the إخفاء takes place is that you move the tongue towards, not completely at, but towards the مخرج of the letter that follows the نون ساكنة. طيب, and you accompany that, you hold the tongue there and you accompany it with غنة. So you say أنصدوكم, so the tongue moves towards the مخرج of the صاد. It doesn't quite hit the مخرج of the صاد, but it gets close to it. طيب, and then you accompany, you hold the tongue there and then you accompany that that letter or that tongue where you've held it, you accompany it with a غنة for two vowel counts. أنصدوكم أن تعتدوا. طيب, and this is of course for the letters of الإخفاء. صف ذا ثنا كم جاد شخص قد سما دم طيبا زد في تقى ضع ظالما. والله تعالى أعلم. We've come to the end of this lesson or this chapter. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.